Take vampire movies. Why are they always set in L.A. or Mexico? They can't even get a tan. If I was a bloodsucker, I'd move to the North Pole.
Went this one long night.
Yeah, and what would you eat? Suck blood from penguins?
Nah, Eskimos, man. Eskimos.
What the hell?
With the guns. Trust me, you don't want to piss Muerte off.
Gentlemen, let's do business.
Green for green.
Cheers at green-eyed angels.
Amen.
This would have gone down as a narcotics arrest. The transparent cylinders glowed green, full of Valkyr. It was dirty money. There was a key on the table. The antique switchboard was still in use. There was an old telephone switchboard in the back room of the reception area, the kind that made phone tapping child's play. It wasn't hard to picture a fat pimp sweating with headphones on, listening to his hookers talk dirty and fake orgasms over a web of party lines, the blood veins of New York. Right now, there was a different set of moans and groans going on.
Boss, Cornelius, this Max Payne. He came, started capitalist. He killed him.
Are you freaking kidding me? He's just one lousy cop. You better be freaking kidding me. Whack him. What's the freaking problem? Hello? Answer me. Hello?
The word was out. A deadly virus released into the city's corrupt circulatory system. Something wicked this way comes. Max Payne at large. Thank you.
my money? You know who you're dealing with? Huh? Do you? Do you?
Turn around, walk away, blow town. That would have been the smart thing to do. Another bomb exploded inside the closest slum building. It was a lucky break. The goons inside were spooked, but luck always came with a price tag. More bombs could still be ticking inside, and the cops would already be on their way. Jack Lupino's suite was on the top floor. At least it used to be, before the explosive makeover.